Good morning, children. Sai Ram. Hope you all are doing well and staying safe at home. So, children, in our previous video, we have gone through your English course book, and in this video, we will go through your English grammar book. I hope you all are familiar with this subject as you have studied this subject in your previous class also. Okay, now, children, you can see in your display, this is the cover page of your English grammar book. Now let's see contents. Total we are having how many chapters? 14. And today we will begin with the first chapter, that is nouns. Okay, your chapter first is nouns. So, children, can you imagine what will happen if you don't have any name? If the place where you are living, if that place also doesn't have any name, how will you tell about yourself to others? Will other people able to identify you, understand you, or recognize you? Will that be possible? No. So name is very important. Why? Because name gives you a identification. It gives you a identity. Children, you must have seen in your school ID card, the first thing which is written there is your name, and then your parents' name, and then your address. Those things are what? It is your identity. So name gives you a identity. So name is very important. So children, in this chapter you will going to learn about what is noun, okay, and its examples, different kinds of nouns and their examples. So let's begin. So you can see in your screen a colorful picture is there, right? You can see children's, what are they doing? They are playing. And where they are playing? In the park, right? Dog, cat, monkey, cloud, mountain, trees, all things are present here, right? So children, what are all these things? Here, children is person. Children is referring to person, okay? Now dog, cat, monkey, what are all these? These all are animals. These all are animals. And then mountain, cloud, tree, what are all these? These all are things. These all are things. And at last, park. Park is what? Park is a place. Okay, park is a place. Where children are playing? They are playing in the park. So park is a place. So that means, children, noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Okay, now let's see definition of noun. Here, nouns are those which name a person, place, animal and thing. Repeat with me, children. Nouns are those which name a person, place, animal and thing. And in simple word, noun is a naming word. Noun is a naming word. Okay, now let's see example here. This man is reading. Here man is the underlined word. What it is referring to? Person. Man here is a person. Okay. Lion lives in a den. Cuckoo is a bird that sings. Here lion and bird. What are these? What are these? Animals. What are these? Animals. And then fruits are good for health. We go to the market to buy vegetables. These are things. Okay. And where do they go to buy vegetables? To the market. So market is place. That means noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Okay. Okay, children. So noun is clear to you all. Noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Now we will learn about kinds of nouns. Children, these all are very important. So we will going to learn in detail. Okay, we will going to understand all these nouns in detail. So here we are going to learn five type kinds of nouns. Common noun, proper noun, collective noun, countable noun and uncountable noun. So let's begin with the first kind of noun, that is common noun. So children, you can see in your screen, we have four pictures. cat, boy, house, flowers. Now here, cat is animal, boy is person, house and flower is thing. That means all these things are what? These all are nouns. Okay, these all are nouns. But why are they common? Why they are common noun? Because common noun refers to the name common to all person or things of the same kind. Remember this, same kind. Okay, common noun refers to the name common to all person or things of the same kind. Okay, boy, girl, city, book, country, river, and all these are example of common noun. Why they are common? Because they don't have any name. We are just using the general term to refer all these things or person. We use a general term. Okay, that is why they are common noun. Now let's see example. Common noun is a common name, general name used for a person, place, thing. Here person is girl. It can be boy also. Here place is city and thing is toy. That is why they are common noun, because we use these terms in general. Okay, these are common name. That is why it is a common noun. Now let's see what is proper noun. Proper noun refers to the name of a particular place, person, thing. Particular or specific person, place, thing. That is why it is a proper noun. Here it is a proper noun. Example can be Taj Mahal, New Delhi, Rohan, etc. Now let's see example. Proper noun is a specific name, okay, for a person, place, thing. There in the first picture you can see, here person is girl, and here person is girl, there person is girl, and here person is Emily. Now that girl got a name and her name is Emily. From common noun she became what? Proper noun, because she got what? Name. Okay, she became a proper noun because she got a name, and name is Emily. Their place was city, here place is Seattle. From common it is changed to proper. Here thing, their thing was toy, and here thing is teddy bear. Same, common noun is changed to proper noun. So common noun, which we use, which is common to all person or things of the same kind, and proper noun, which is used for a specific person, place or thing. Okay, let's see more example. Here Rosie is a beautiful girl. First of all, children, always remember this, proper noun always begin with the capital letter. First word will always be your capital letter of a proper noun, not common, only proper noun. Okay, so Rosie is a beautiful girl. Here girl is common noun because this is a general term, and here Rosie is a proper noun because it is a specific name of a person. Okay, here Dadar is a railway station. Station is general term, that is why it is common. Dadar is proper because it is a specific name of a station. Okay, here Silk is my pet dog. Dog is general term. Why? That is what is common. Silk is proper because it is a specific name of a dog. So children, to understand this concept more clearly, let's quickly see a video.
Hi friends, common and proper. The general name of a person, place, animal or a thing is a common noun. For example, he is a clown. In this sentence, we are talking about a clown. Clown is a general name for the person. They live in a city. In this sentence, we are talking about a city. City is a general name for the place. It is his dog. In this sentence, We are talking about a dog. Dog is a general name for the animal. This is a pastry. In this sentence, we are talking about a pastry. Pastry is a general name for the thing. Common nouns are not capitalized unless they begin a sentence or are part of a title. Special names given to people, places, pets, days, months, organizations, etc. are proper nouns. For example, John, the clown, entertains people in a circus. In this sentence, we are talking about John, the clown. John is a special name for the clown. They live in Mumbai. In this sentence, we are talking about Mumbai, a city. Mumbai is the special name for the city. His dog's name is Pluto. In this sentence, we are talking about Pluto the dog. Pluto is the special name for the dog. All proper nouns begin with capital letters. The special name given to a country, city, road, river, mountain, monument, festival, etc. is a proper noun. All the words in a proper noun begin with a capital letter. For example, my uncle lives in New Zealand. The Red Fort is situated in New Delhi. My school is on Mahatma Gandhi Road.
So I hope, children, you enjoyed watching this video and learn more about common and proper noun. So now let's move forward. Okay, so children, you can see in your screen we are having four pictures here, right? Picture of a book, soldier, student and key. Now let's see other picture. Here we can see picture of books, soldiers, students and keys. Now here it is one and here it is more than one. So we can say group of books, group of soldiers, group of students, group of keys. Okay, it is conveying meaning, but does it sound good? No, it doesn't. So instead of group, we can use some other word, some specific word. So what can be that specific word? That is a collective noun. So let's see what is collective noun first. Collective noun refers to the name of a group or collection. From the word itself, you can understand collective means collection. Okay, collection of many. Here, many books are there, many soldiers are there, many students are there, many keys are there, right? So that means, in simple words, when one word is used for the group, is called as a collective noun. So that means instead of group, we can use that one particular word. It will sound good and it will look more stylish. So children, I want you all to learn as much as possible the examples of more collective nouns, and please write it down in your rough notebook. Okay, so here, words used for the one word used for the group is called collective noun. Example can be crowd, bunch, team, class, etc. Now let's see some more example of collective noun here. A flock of sheep, that means here group of sheep. Instead of group, what we used? Flock. A herd of elephants, group of elephants. Instead of group, what we are using? Herd. An army of soldiers. Instead of group, what we are using? Army. So this is a specific word. Instead of group, we can use these words. Okay, we can use these terms. A bundle of sticks, a bunch of grapes, a pile of books. So it is it sounds more good and more stylish. Okay, it sounds better. Now let's see some more example. An army of ants, a flock of sheep, a pride of lions, a school of fish, a paddling of ducks. So these all are what? Collective nouns. So children, try to learn as much as possible and please write it down in your notebook also. Okay, so children, before we move further, let's see a video again.
Collective nouns. Ricky and Nikki are at an animal farm. Look at the interesting banners they have come across at the farm. A herd of cows. A flock of birds. A swarm of flies. Some common nouns have a special name when they are in a group. A collective noun is a word used to name a group of people, animals, or things. The words herd, flock, swarm are collective nouns used to refer to groups of cows, birds, and flies respectively. Let us look at some more collective nouns. Pack is a collective noun which refers to a group of dogs. School is a collective noun which refers to a group of. Bunch is a collective noun which refers to a group of keys. Team is a collective noun which refers to a group of horses. Class is a collective noun which refers to a group of students. Troop is a collective noun which refers to a group of monkeys. A collective noun is singular in form, even though it names anything which is two or more than two. For example, a set of tools, a bale of cotton, a deck of cards. Such group of words is called a noun phrase.
So I hope children you understand it more clearly. Now let's move forward. So children, you can see picture of orange and bags in your screen. So let's count together. How many oranges are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many are there? 5. Now let's count bags. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many bags are there? 9. Okay, now let's see other picture. So what is this? This is countable noun from the word itself, countable, which can be counted using number. which can be counted using number. Here you can count oranges also and bags also, right, using number. So that is a countable noun which we can count using number. Example can be girl, book, school, etc. Okay, now children, can you count water? Can you count this milk? How many milk is there? How many water is there? Can you answer? No. But if I will ask, how much water is there? How much milk is there? Now you can answer, yes, you can say there is little water or there is some water, there is little milk or there is some milk. So countable noun, you can say how many, because we can count using number. But in uncountable noun, you cannot say how many, because you cannot count water, you cannot count milk. Okay, we can only measure the quantity. That is a uncountable noun, that means which cannot be counted using number. That is, example can be air, water, beauty. Can you count air? No. Can you count water? No. Only we can tell the quantity, right? Okay, so let's see some more example here. Eggs, banana, olive, fries, burger, hot dog, apple, carrots, tomatoes, watermelon. These all are countable noun because we can count them individually using number. And these all are uncountable noun. Milk, flour, salt, sugar, jam, meat, rice, honey, tea, cheese. You cannot count these things. We can only measure the quantity. Okay, you can say 1 cup of milk, 1 bottle of milk, or 1 glass of water, but you cannot count water, you cannot count milk. That is why it is uncountable noun. So again, let's see a video to understand it.
Nouns, countable and uncountable. Countable nouns have plural forms. For example, spoon, spoons, student, students. Uncountable nouns do not have plural forms. For example, snow, snow, flower, flower, jam, jam. Countable nouns are objects that can be counted as separate units using numbers. For example, 2 spoons, 6 students. Uncountable nouns are objects that cannot be separated and counted individually. We use quantifiable words such as much, some, or a little before uncountable nouns to quantify them. For example, much snow, some flour, a little jam. Abstract nouns are mostly uncountable. For example, patriotism, courage, laziness. The phrase how many is combined with countable nouns. For example, how many hill stations have you visited so far? The phrase how much is combined with uncountable nouns. For example, how much oil should I pour in the pan? The determiner any is used in negative sentences with countable as well as uncountable nouns. For example, I have not brought any notebook today. There isn't going to be any basketball practice today.
So I hope children you understand it more clearly. Okay, countable noun can be plural, but uncountable noun will always be singular. Okay, you can say eggs, you can say bananas, olives, rice, but you cannot say milks, flowers, salts, sugars. Okay, so it will always be singular, and countable noun can be plural. Okay, so children, let's quickly recall what we have learned today. First, nouns are those which name a person, place, animals and things. Example can be girl, boy, city, dog, etc. Common noun which name the person, place, animal, things in general. We use in general term. That can be girl, boy, until and unless they don't get any name, they considered as a common noun. Okay, we use general term for them. Proper noun refers to the particular name of a person, place, animals or thing. Name can be Rahul, place can be New Delhi, animal can be dog. And if the pet dog you are having, if that dog has a name, that will be considered as a proper noun. Example can be Tommy. Okay, collective noun is when one word is used for the group, like crowd, bunch, class, right? Countable noun which can be counted using number. We can count individually. Okay, an uncountable noun which cannot be counted using number. Countable noun can be in a plural form, but uncountable noun always will be singular. Okay, so children, you have to do this homework. Here, first, underline the nouns in the following sentences and write whether they are common noun or proper noun in the columns given. First is, Jaipur is a big city. First, you have to underline the noun, which one is common and which one is proper. Here, Jaipur is a big city. City is a common noun. Jaipur is a proper noun, because city is a general term of common noun and Jaipur is a specific name. That is why it is a proper noun. Second sentence, Sheila is a doctor. Sheila is name of a person. That is why it is a proper noun, and doctor is a common noun. Rita is a brave girl. Here Rita will be proper noun and girl will be common noun. Now fill in the blanks with the words given below. Okay, first, the dash of people gathered here. The crowd of people gathered here. I saw a dash of sheep, flock of sheep. Dash smell sweet, flowers smell sweet. Dash is the capital of India. Delhi is the capital of India. Say what collection each collective noun stands for. Here, herd stands for elephant. Bunch stands for flowers or keys or grapes. Class stands for students and army stands for soldier. Now, D, underline the countable noun and circle the uncountable nouns in the following sentences. We breathe in the air. Here, which one is noun? Air. But which noun? Uncountable or countable? Uncountable. That means what you have to do? You have to circle it. Second, put some sugar in my milk. Here, sugar, milk, both are uncountable noun. Rose is a beautiful flower. Now, here, rose is what? Countable noun. Okay, you can count rose, right? Okay, so children, you have one more thing to do, that is worksheet. Okay, so let's discuss. Choose the correct option. First, what is a noun? So you have three options here. So three options are, first is action word, describing word, naming word. Noun is a naming word. The word library is a person, place, thing, place. Proper noun always begin with a capital letter, period, different letter, capital letter. Which of these is a proper noun? town kitten John. John is a proper noun because it is a name of a specific person. Now you have to write three nouns that name a person, place, thing, animal. This you can do by yourself. Third, you have to rewrite the sentences given below. You have to use capital letters for proper noun wherever it is needed. First, he lives in a small town named Janakpur. Now here, town is what? Town is a common noun because it is a general term of a place. But Janakpur is a specific name of a place. So Janakpur is a proper noun. So that means you have to write J in a capital letter. Second, I have a cat, I call him Tommy. Here Tommy is a proper noun. You have to write it in capital letter. My best friend is Hari, he lived in Bhopal. Now both name of a person, name of a place, both you have to write in capital. Question 4, you have to find the common noun. I loved staying at your house in the week. Now house is a common noun. Second, I am lucky to spend time with my friend. Here friend is a common noun. I enjoyed going to the park. Here park is a common noun. Now question 5 is you have to fill the blanks, okay? And this question is from collective noun. A dash of grapes, a bunch of grapes, a dash of lions, a dash of a pride of lions, a dash of fish, a school of fish, and dash of ants, an army of ants. So I hope children you enjoyed learning this chapter and it is clear to you all, and I hope you all will be able to do your homework. And children, assignment, you have to do it online and you have to submit, and this homework you have to do it in your rough notebook, okay? Whatever notebook you are having with yourself, you can do in that. So children, till then, take care of yourself. Have a nice day. Sai Ram.